What's the most embarrassing thing that's happened to you on campus?
Oh my God, this is hilarious. Okay.
Welcome to LTU's Pass It On. This is a game where students create a chain by asking and answering each other's questions.
It can be any question?
No question is off limits, so things can get out of hand pretty quick.
What is happiness to you? You know, what is happiness to you? So yeah.
Oh, okay. happiness, probably like, you know, I don't know. I don't know if I'm equipped to answer this question. I don't think it has an answer, to be honest. It's probably just like a feeling that you have, a state, you know? I guess I'll go along a similar line of the last person, asking like what sadness is and how they deal with that in college, I guess.
What's sad to me is sort of, I feel like, getting scared of losing passion for something that actually matters and something that can impact people, and coming in and seeing so many people excited about that, and myself as well, and going through like the conflict of figuring out doing something that matters versus doing something that kind of puts you in a life that it seems like everybody wants to be in as well. I think it's just talking to all different people. It's talking to your professors, it's talking to your parents, talking to your friends, and finding your own way. And this time, also just not being afraid to try different things as well. Like, what do you care about, and why do you care about that, and how does that apply to your life?
I care about nature and like the natural world. And so right now what I'm hoping to do is environmental engineering or environmental studies. Just because, like I said, grew up from a super small town that had a huge influence on, nature had a huge influence on me when I was growing up. And so I've always like wanted to give back to that somehow. And so for me, that's probably what I care about and why I'm doing what I'm doing here. I guess what do they like to do for fun, right? Like, what do they do outside classes?
Oh, I feel like most of the fun at Yale really happens. I mean, there's great stuff that happens in the class, but let's see, outside of class, well, I'm a singer. I sing with my a cappella group, Shades. And that's like probably my biggest thing I do on campus is sing music with them. So that's what I like to do for fun. I also do lots of theater. I'm a yoga teacher, so I teach yoga classes. Yeah, that's what I do for fun. Your three favorite songs right now. Three songs that you're just like really vibing with right now.
My three favorite songs right now? Okay. All right, this is going to be a really weird mix of songs. It is Bonfire by Childish Gambino, Cash Out by Calvin Harris, and then the classic from Mulan, I'll Make a Man Out of You. I think they're just the things I played most recently on Spotify. So if you had to be trapped on an island, a desert island with one Yale professor, who would it be?
Oh, that's a really good question. One Yale professor. I'm trying to think who my professors are this semester. Probably I really like my Arabic professor, Elham. She's really fun, and also she's like, I don't know, like I feel like she'd just be a cool person to be trapped on an island with. I feel like we'd have interesting conversations. What is one thing that you feel like you could never be fulfilled without? Like, what's one thing that you need in order to like feel fulfilled?
A space I can be myself in. Just completely, completely myself. What is the food you miss most from home?
So because I'm originally from China, I think I miss all kinds of Chinese food. Especially rice noodles, I would say.
What is the food you miss most from home?
Soft tofu soup. I think that's what it's called in English. Everything from Korea, they basically don't have good Korean food here, I don't think. What's the most interesting class you've taken?
Let's see, that's tough. I'm taking a class called Cultural Appropriation and the Ethics of Musical Representation. It's a long name, but we talk about basically, we start out with cultural appropriation just in itself in general, and different examples of that, and then we kind of relate that to music. Today in class, I just came from actuality and using like Asian music, but for Western practices like yoga now, it doesn't identify under a specific religious institution, But there's like, for me, I use yoga for its physical benefits and I completely disregard the religious aspects, which, so maybe I'm an offender of religious, you know, of cultural appropriation, but everyone is to some extent. That's just like something interesting to learn about. And also I'm a big music fan, so we cover some of like, you know, some old music, some new stuff, and it's just a really cool class, yeah. What's the most embarrassing thing that's happened to you on campus?
Oh my God, this is hilarious. Okay. All right, last year, drunk Kev, I kind of like stumbled into my room, in my dorm room, and I crawled into bed, and I was like, that's it. I drank a lot of water, I had food, I'm gonna be A-okay, sleep it off. 30 minutes later, I feel the urge to throw up, and this is like at 10 p.m. So I was like, I run to the bathroom, and in my haste, I forgot to leave like the slipper in the door, and so I run to the bathroom in my boxers, and I like kind of throw up in the sink, and I start cleaning up the sink, you know, I don't wanna leave, and there was some throw up on the wall, it was terrible. I go back to my room, and the door is locked, and it's freezing, this is winter time, I don't have my phone, so then I'm like in my boxers, like, there's still a little vomit, like, I knock on my neighbor's door, and I was like, hey, can you help me call campus security? And I knock like three times, and finally my neighbor like opens the door, and she's kind of like, this girl I haven't really talked to, looks me up and down, and calls campus security. Then I'm out here in the hallway waiting, like it's getting so cold, like I'm just like shivering outside my door, and campus security doesn't come. So I go back to the girl and I'm like, can you please call campus security again? And they're like, sorry, like we had a lot of calls tonight. Finally this dude comes, he opens the door, and then I walk into my room, and lo and behold, my roommate is there, and he's asleep in his bed. And I was so confused, like, here's what I must have happened. While I was in the bathroom, my roommate came in, and I wasn't smart enough to knock on the door and ask him to open the door. So I was just like uber confused, like I realized everything that was happening the next day after. There was still like vomit on the wall, like it was like 11 a.m. on a Sunday, and I'm like with a Lysol wipe, like cleaning up after my aftermath. It was pretty embarrassing. Maybe who do you admire most in your college and why?
Probably my health and sickness professor, Carolyn Roberts. I just think she has like the best energy, and she does really impressive research, and like she handles this, like the subject matter is really difficult. It's about like health and sickness during slavery, and she just couldn't handle it any better. Which dining hall is the best?
Ben Franklin. Yeah, I really love their ramen bar, and they have a general good variety of choices. All right, what's the best movie you've watched in the past year?
In the past year, The Prestige. My cousin told me to watch it, and I'd never heard of it in my life, but it's on Netflix, and it has Hugh Jackman and Christian Bale, and it's about magic, so I was like, but it's actually the greatest movie ever, and it blew my mind several times, and I was just like, it was crazy.